Hello, folks. This is the third vlog in my theology series. So, book recommendation, Systematic Theology. That's the topic I'm going to be covering in this video. And what is systematic theology? Fortunately, we have an answer. What is systematic theology? Many different definitions have been given, but for the purposes of this book, the following definition will be used. Systematic theology is any study that answers the question, what does the whole Bible teach us today about any given topic? I think that's simple enough. That's what systematic theology is. It is, what does the whole Bible teach us about a specific topic? There are many, many segments to this, to systematic theology, and essentially, let's see here, you know, what, like, the Bible, like, how you approach the Bible is part of it. Does God exist? Can we know God? The character of God. How is God different from us? You know, there's a whole big long thing. The doctrine of man, sin, the covenants, who the persons of God. God the Father, the Son, Holy Spirit, you know, here we go. This is a divisive subject. The doctrine of the application of redemption. Election. Don't hit me. And there's some things that are like, how do you become saved? Like, what is the mechanism of salvation? You know, how does that happen? All that, you know, do we need God's assistance to make that happen? Is that our own free will? You know, what, you're getting into some sticky territory when you start getting into soteriology, which is the study of salvation. The doctrine of the church, ecclesiology is what that's called, and, you know, how does the church work? How is the church governed? What are the essential parts of it? How do we organize our church services? You know, what is the church? And my personal favorite, the doctrine of the future. The aka future prophecy, aka eschatology, or the study of end times. Fun stuff. It's not fun stuff. It's really not fun stuff. But, you know, it's fun to study, I guess. So we've got, like, you know, the return of Christ. The millennium. What is the millennium? When does the millennium happen? You know, what's the judgment all about? Oh, man. So many fun things in that. And that's pretty much it. That's in a nutshell. I think that's the most important bits of it. Like I said, systematic theology, Wayne Grudem. You can buy this at, like, half price books really cheap these days. I mean, like, just like hardback and everything, man. You can get the systematic theology books. This isn't the only systematic theology, but it's my personal favorite. I like the layout of it. It's got all, like, I mean, it is a tome. I don't know if I showed you that part of it, but I mean, it's a book. It's a good reference guide. Like, you know, I wouldn't encourage people to just kind of read through this whole thing, all like just page after page after page. You know, stick with a little bit at a time, just like this video series is about. You know, you gotta take it in just like a kernel, just tiny little bits at a time. Now, if you find something interesting that you're like, huh, I don't know anything about this, but this sounds interesting, definitely read on that. I don't want you to get discouraged, because this is like, you know, this is the kind of stuff that causes Bible college students to fall asleep in class. Not that I ever, well, I may have on one or two occasions fallen asleep in class. That's a separate matter. Yeah. So, we'll get into some of these specific areas, and I'll try to go over each one of them in just a little bit of detail, not too much. Something that's like, you know, I just want to pique your curiosity. That's my goal here. I don't want to lecture you for hours on end about a topic. You can read it yourself, and you can learn yourself. It's really not that hard. All it takes is interest. And given that you're watching these videos, you're probably interested. So I would encourage you to, I guess, facilitate that interest as much as possible. Really, it's about anything and everything. You know, you should research things. You should use your brain. And in a lot of these matters, you have to use your brain. It's not spelled out. So there are some significant disagreements that people have over systematic theology. You know, does soteriology being a big one. I mean, how, you know, are we saved of our own free will? I mean, do we get to choose? Is that all decided beforehand and we have no say in it? Is it the paradoxical view? Is it like, okay, well, you know, God chooses who are saved, and, you know, secondarily, like, is our free will incompatible with God's sovereign choice? You know, does God sovereignly choose to give us free will? I mean, how does that all work? I mean, this is something that scholars still disagree about. I don't want to get too wrapped up in that, but that's one of the more sticky subjects. But also, you know, church, the way church leadership is handled. You know, a lot of churches have, like, just one guy, pretty much, that's, like, in charge of everything, and then you have, like, a board. And so it's kind of like a top-down, where's my finger, there it is, top-down type of leadership. Sometimes it's like hierarchical, like the Catholic Church. Sometimes it's like just a board of elders that decide things. And the pastor is there. He's usually one of the elders. And they decide things like as a group. So, which I personally think is the right way to do it. But, I mean, it's not the only school of thought. Okay, so, honestly, any one of these areas is going to have controversial subjects. And that's what makes it so fun! Okay, so, the You want to talk about controversial subjects that people believe a lot of different things about. Let's talk about eschatology, the end times. Like, some people believe that the end times already happened. Some people believe that it's happening right now. A lot of people believe that. And some people, you know, say it's like, it's in the future. You know, it's like, it's something that's, you know, far distant in the future that, you know, maybe we probably won't even experience it. There are some people that say, like, okay, well, this has been happening. You know, this is something that's like, it's happened in the past, it's happened, you know, more recently in the past, it's happening now, it's happening in the future. You know, it's like, there's all kinds of different ideas going in there. And, you know, there are so many things here that I don't really want to get into all at once. You know, it's like, this is going to be something that is, it's a long process going through every single one of these individual points, but I want to help you through it, and I don't want to make your decisions for you. You need to use your own brain to come to your own conclusion. Thinking critically, in my opinion, is the most important part. If you're not willing to think critically, you're going to just absorb things, come to other people's conclusions, and they aren't necessarily the right ones. You need to be on guard. Okay. I think that about sums it up for this overview of systematic theology. I look forward to going into more detail on individual segments of systematic theology.